it out to our audience, which is surprising that we've actually got an audience for this podcast.
It's me, mate. That's why I said bring me on.
Just asking yourself questions.
So we've asked them. We said, right, if you've got any questions for him, let us know. So we'll rattle through these. The first one is from Mrs. Beard.
All right.
Yeah. She said, "You best ask him his favourite place to eat garlic bread."
I can't overstate the importance of this, because she said before I left the house this morning, she said, "You make sure you find out where he says does the best garlic bread around this area." So pressure, but
so garlic bread. So in here in Morley, there's a restaurant, Sambuca's.
That's a restaurant.
Yeah.
Sambuca's. Right, yeah. Named after a drink.
Yeah. Okay. And they do some more like garlic bread in there.
Sambuca's in Morley. Right, okay.
Give it a go. That's a beauty, is that like?
So Sambuca's is the answer then in Morley.
Remember that, because I'll forget.
Fair do.
Well, you can just rewind.
Right, so Joe Murray Funk. So Joe, he's the guy that helped design the branding for the podcast. He asked, "What's your biggest gripe when ordering the takeaway?" His is putting cold drinks in the same bag. For me, it's actually when they put salads in the little food bag and it just goes soggy and mushy. Like, why do they do that?
I think it's like, so the sandwich I've just had with the tomatoes in, that's just turned it really, really soggy. I think sometimes, like with burgers, they can put that much stuff in them. And you probably have this, you can't even pick it up. It's sliding here, there, and everywhere. Yeah. That's a bit of a gripe I have sometimes. You know, the quantity sometimes can just ruin the meal. If it's too big, if they build it too big and put too much sloppy stuff in, you can't eat it as a burger. You've got to get knife and fork out, haven't you?
Too many cooks spoil the broth.
Absolutely.
As they say.
Family Heart Fun Food asked, "What's the fanciest takeaway you got that didn't taste as good as it looked?"
Oh, fanciest one.
That is a great question, by the way. Who was that?
Family Heart Fun Food.
Can we give him a top fan badge or something like that? Because that's a really good question.
Yeah. I think, so this was one of the other lowest scores that I got. So it was back in the beginning and we went to the hometown of Barnsley. So I was all giddy thinking my first review. Went to a dessert place and it looked amazing. And I'm thinking, oh, this is all right. And then when I just ate it, oh, it's horrible. It just didn't taste how it would look. These desserts, the waffles, they were rock hard. And I'm thinking, you know, they've got these bourbon biscuits that probably smart price from Tazda sprinkled on top. The cameraman is just sat there and I just look so drained, because I'm thinking I was so giddy at going back and it was a nice big place and all these desserts. And I thought, it's just ain't right. So, yeah, dessert place in Barnsley.
You mentioned the cameraman there. And obviously he's like, nobody knows what he looks like. But
it's like the Stig from Top Gear.
He is like the Stig.
Not that I used to watch Top Gear.
You know what he is actually like? He is a little exclusive. He looks like the guy from... Can I say it?
No, you can't give it out. No, you can't say it.
They're not allowed to say it looks like someone.
He does. We'll bleep all this out. It looks like...
What's wrong with saying that? Why can't we say that?
Because then people know what he looks like.
Yeah, well...
They'll be hounding him. It's quite unique.
He looks a little bit like... The cameraman on Rip My Takeaway.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
Next question from _the_Mank. So _the_Mank asked, "How has fame affected you and your family?" We touched on it briefly before, but
so obviously it's helped us through a difficult time. So I can't thank people enough for watching it and continue to watch it, because it's helped us move on in a difficult time. Well, but sort of like look forward to the best things that we can.
That's really nice. I mean, it's obviously unthinkable what you went through, the highest of, like, the lowest of lows, and then through to the highest of highs, you know.
Yeah, and it's obviously, if this hadn't happened, I'd still be working a full-time job, which would be more stressful, because I wouldn't be able to spend as much time as I do with my children.
Absolutely.
So it's allowed me to sort of spend that quality time really with my family, which I appreciate more than anything.
That's amazing. Cam Chana asked, "Do you eat anything healthy when you're not filming Rate My Takeaway?"
Absolutely love salad.
I thought that was a joke. I didn't want to laugh. But
no, through summertime I do, but I like, you know, jacket potatoes and stuff like that. So I just, when I'm not filming, just try and keep it without, you know, to be honest, I don't really enjoy takeaways now, if I'm honest, because I'm eating that many. It's not, I won't think, oh, do you know what? I'll go get a bit of burger or a kebab. You know what I mean? But I love Sunday dinners, and I love pasta, I love bolognese and lasagna and stuff like that. So I'll usually cook those kind of meals at home.
Nice one, right. James McClaw has asked, what would be your last meal?
Ooh, that's a good
death row or whatever it would be.
Yeah, so you're on death row, right? You're about to get the lethal cocktail of injections.
Ooh.
What you choose? I'm just setting the scene. You're not actually on death row. You get to choose a meal. What's it going to be?
For me, it would be home-cooked chips.
Nice.
All right.
Deep fried, or we're not talking like McCain's, right? We're talking like deep fried.
Yeah, proper, you know, uncut, deep fried, nice. Proper chips, lathered in salt and vinegar, fat as peas. I love them. Like processed peas, boil the heck out of them.
Oh, those ones that come out, they look like grey. They're not even green anymore. They're like grey.
No, they're green.
They've got a bit blue.
And then it's got to be a beautiful, big, thick ribeye steak. I love ribeye. Absolutely beautiful. I like the marbling on it. I love that nice bit of fat. So that would be like my last sort of meal with a treacle sponge and custard.
Oh, that's a solid, mate. Put it there.
Bang.
That is a meal. That's a proper English meal as well,
that's
right?
Solid, that. Yeah, that's, I fancy that. I should go for dinner after
this. Treacle sponge as well after that. Yeah, that's cool.
Tannets04 has asked, when are you getting a new chair?
Well, when this one breaks, which, you know, it could be any day.
I saw you in Birmingham on one of your videos and you looked like you were going to topple over onto a roundabout.
I swear to God, there's a bit of wobble on it. So I think like one of the pins, I think it's going, so it ain't going to be long, but I've decided that we'll just hang out until it goes.
The best case scenario would be if you get the moment it breaks on camera and you're eating some food, it's just backwards off your seat.
Yeah. So, and you can bet your bottom dollar it'll be something like, you know, when we do US tour or something like that, when I can't just go to Bianco and get another one.
You're missing the trick here. We need to get Rate My Takeaway chairs, fold out chairs.
Well, that's it, yeah. Watch the merch, darling.
There better be a chair on there now.
So Tom J Man 8 has asked, does the cameraman ever get fed? We've touched on that earlier.
Yeah, he does. So obviously he'll pile straight into the food when I've done. He gets in there, and obviously some of the stuff is like, he'll say to me, don't touch that side of it. I want that side. You know what I mean? But yeah, he does get food. People think he don't get fed, but he does.
Ah, he does. You can see he's a unit. It looks like he's been lifting like you. You've not seen. You'll never see him, will you? But
he must be bigger than me. I'm only a little.
Paul Chadwick has asked, if you could open a takeaway of your own, what would it be?
Oh,
what does he mean? Like what kind of cuisine?
That was the question. So we can.
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest, I think you know the way that the takeaways are going. It like the burger scene at the moment is pretty popular, and coming into like the gourmet burgers and stuff like that. But I think I'd like to do something that could switch it up. I think, you know, you could like 1 month do burgers and 1 month do curries. And, you know, I think that'd be pretty cool where you didn't know what the menu is.
Nightmare that though for stocking, wouldn't it be? You have to, each month you can have different stuff.
Yeah. So
I reckon you should do it. I would totally eat at the Rate My Takeaway if if it was like proper like English group, like you. You wouldn't
so like the steak, chips and peas.
You wouldn't really get steak as a takeaway, would you? But what about like some?
Oh no, there are some steak takeaways out there. Yeah, there's not one so far away from here.
I don't think that would travel too well. But yeah. I mean, like, I'm thinking like maybe like shepherd's pie and peas, that kind of thing. Yeah.
You know, there aren't many of those. Steak and ale pie. Oh, how's that? A bit of steak and I love pies. Yeah. As you can tell, but
yeah, that'd be neat.
Yeah.
You'd clean the floor at this time of year. Now it's getting a bit colder, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's the thing. It's like, so a lot of the cafes now, obviously, they do specials, don't they, with stews and bolognese and all that kind of stuff, chilies and that, and they do a lot better doing them at dinner time this time of year than they do through the day doing sandwiches.
You could do like a Mr. Beast has, you know, he's got all those ghost kitchens. He doesn't actually have restaurants.
Yeah.
He just has ghost kitchens. You could do like a Rate My Takeaway brand and you just sell out of like a...
Mate, we need to send him an invoice for consultancy. Yeah, we're building the brand.
Told you, mate, it's all for charity.
Lindsay Walden asked, she didn't really ask, she just made a statement and then everybody in the comments hammered her, but she said, why does he give out so many tens? Some of the food he's eating looks awful. He doesn't even look like he enjoys it. Be more critical, ! But in the comment section.
Troll along.
Yeah. So basically, obviously, like I said, how the channel works is we're asking people to tell us what the best takeaways are. So, you know, I'm going to these places and they're all right. And when I first started out, you know, I went to these takeaways and they didn't have a clue and they're like, yeah, whatever. And obviously when I go now, a lot of them recognise me and I say to them, look, you know, don't overdo it. Because we've had one that gave me a massive monster box and then when somebody went and said, I want that one he had.
Yeah.
Nowhere near as big. So, you know what I mean? It's down to them. But the reason why I give the tens is because it's quality stuff and it is my opinion. You know what I mean? But also, it's like I said, I'm taking into consideration you know, the service, how it is inside, you know, when it comes to me, is it piping up? You know what I mean? Because some takeaways, it's like, you'll know yourself, you can go to a chicken shop and it's probably been sat there for 3 hours in a warmer, and it's not right warm when you get it. It's not as if it's come out fresh, is it? So I'm looking at all that kind of stuff and incorporating it all into the rating. But the main thing is the service. I find wherever you go, if it's a takeaway, a cafe or whatever, if you walk in and somebody's like, good morning, how are you doing? What would you like today? How's your day been? You just feel more at ease, and straight away you're in that, oh, this is great. If you walk it, what can I get you, pal?
Yeah.
What do you want?
Yeah, in addition to that, I think we were talking about this before. There's an element as well. Okay, you might not want to give tens out all the time, but by the same token, you're not going to just go in and be like, oh, this is a 2 out of 10, because you have like a responsibility, I think, anyway, especially if you're a nice bloke, to not end somebody's career, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Because you know, you never know what's happened that day. It might have an off day or whatnot, and you don't want to go in and say, oh, this is a terrible takeaway. So although it might be a bit disingenuous, right, to say this is like an 8 out of 10 when maybe it's a 6 out of 10, I think there's a reason for it. And it's not, the reason is that you're a nice bloke and you don't want to destroy reputations.
Like people said about, will you go around and rate the worst takeaways? I just don't know if that's me. I just don't know if I can.
Yeah.
You know, it's like somebody's livelihood, and like you say, they have good days and bad days, and do you really want to go in there and effectively end?
Yeah, absolutely.
What they're doing. And it's like, you know, in my opinion, all right, and some stuff, it's been absolutely bang on. So it's like the two sandwiches there, you know what I mean? You know, that one, it were all right, we're decent, eh? It were a nice basic sandwich, and the other one, a lot better ingredients, tasted a lot better. That's my opinion. You could try that one and think that is absolutely bang on. So our editor, he prefers all the cheap, nasty sausages. You know, he prefers all that than the other ones. So he would have rated that a 10 and probably give that an 8.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Because it's all about personal preference. So when people are saying, oh, why? Yeah, you might not give it a 10. But at the end of the day, it's entertainment. I'm giving my opinion.
Shut the fuck up, guy. So was it a guy or a woman?
A lady. A lady called Lindsay.
Oh, well.
We'll have you at the table, Lindsay, love. We'll have you as a guest.
By the way, Lindsay, we're only joking. So you're sitting down a little bit, relax.
He's off, isn't
he? I know, you're going to get it. What are you getting on? Right, the last question from Mr. William Rowland. Why do you think Beard doesn't have a blue tick on Twitter?
Well, obviously, he's just not got the reach, has he? You know what I mean?
Well, I hate to do this to you, Mr. Rate My Takeaway, but you're not verified on Instagram, and I am, so...
Is that true, is it?
What's Instagram?
Do you have an Instagram? Right, wow. We've got this in the corner of the room.
That's why, because I've not started it much yet, but when we get that next week...